All right. Time currently is 3:20. So one thing that I did note, again, we're gonna date this year, month, day. Only real setting that I'm gonna change is whether or not I drop things when I die. So in my previous 2 hours that I recorded, one thing that I did note was that while it looks like you can play offline, I crashed as soon as I died while not having an active internet connection. So yeah, I'll just leave those where they are. Skin color. I liked being a Smurf. There we go. Give him a borderline reptile eyes. Purplish tone. There we go. Whoa, that's not what I wanted. There we go. Sure. All right. So the main thing that I noticed is that it seems to crash if I'm not connected to the internet. So what I really want to do there is I'm running an hour-long test of start a game and then play it for an hour. And I'm going to try to die at least 5 times. So I have played a little bit, but not a lot. So while I don't know a ton, I know a little bit on how to play, and I also I don't like this starting place, just because, well, the original starting place that I had was, I think I put my base, like, in, it is absolutely impossible to, select a place with the cursor. My initial base, I believe I put it, like, right here. I don't like exactly where I put it, mostly because I had it rotated a little bit and basically locked out a chunk of my flooring. So, a couple of options. One is that apparently I can do a respawn to move to another place, but I don't think I want to do that. I don't think I want to do that. So I have a couple of options. One is to like build it near this thing. Where was the other thing that I'm thinking of? There was another location that I remember. Can I turn off weather effects? Okay, that gave me a little extra distance. I do remember seeing some information on there being a castle. That you can build in, but I don't think I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So, we will go ahead and just build down here, and we'll kind of line it up to be lined up with this structure that's already down here. So, we'll just kind of build around it. Anyway, pick up fallen branches, hit trees for wood. Did not want to stop. There we go. All right, since we are gonna have to build around things in here, I'm just gonna go ahead and put the crafting benches inside. That way, as we build the structure, we don't have to worry about moving our benches. Tells us to unlock the Palsphere. Now it wants us to craft a Palsphere, which I don't think I have. Yeah, don't have any of the stuff for yet, but we're gonna work on that. Main thing is that we need to pick up some wood, some stone. And we need to build both a stone pickaxe and a stone axe. Gonna go with the pickaxe first. I just need another rock. Guess we're gonna have to run around a little bit. There's a rock. Well, that one is too high level for me. I don't have over there any mining locations. Are these parallel? It looks like these are parallel. Okay, so I should actually be able to build around these. Okay. Tells us to unlock a PAL box. So by building over here, that will put me in range of the trees and the stone that's right here. So you can get palladium fragments from the stone. Or at least I've seen it happen. There we go. Second workbench. We're just trying to line up to the wall, and then we'll just back out. I could get the wood by hitting the trees, but I'm pretty sure I get better results with the axe. So I'm going to just pick up the wood instead. Okay, that looks like it's basically lined up. What is it overlapping with? Okay. Whatever. I wondered if it was just the first game that I played that had this, but no, there's apparently just a hidden chest down here. Tells me to craft a Pal Spear. Let me eat and level up my stats. Alright, next is capture 5 lamb balls and earn an XP bonus, access the pal box to summon a pal to your base, and attack pals to weaken them, and then RB throw sphere. Okay. So, lamb balls. Build a wooden chest. I need to unlock that technology. Thank you. Still have two more pal spheres. Why? Oh, this is mine. Duh. Even though we do have a quest for Lamball specifically, I do want to get one of each of the others for the basics. So that means a cat and a chicken. I would catch a couple of these land balls, but I'm out of pal balls, pal spheres. So let's go ahead and collect a little more pal fragments. A little bit of basic wall climbing. We're going to need a total of 30 pal spheres. So I'm basically just, while I'm out, going ahead and collecting as much paldium as I can. Got an effigy, which we are also getting ready to hit nighttime, and at that point we are going to need to head back. Because we'll start suffering damage from cold. But with these two paladium right here, I wanted to go ahead and grab him. Apparently don't have fast travel yet. Not exactly sure why. Is that an unlock? If it is, I don't see where. Okay, so I need two more land balls to make a cloth outfit. Okay. Why can I not back out? I don't know what's holding up there. Oh, cool. My controller's just not listening. There we go. Build campfire. Chest. Okay. There we go. I bet you that's because it's too close to the pal docks. Okay. So the next thing the base wants me to do is build a. Shoddy bed. I mostly want at the moment is to get a small little house built up. Out of wood. All right, need wool and wood. Okay. So we're just gonna place a couple of these. So we need 5 total. We need 5 total beds because that's the most we can put in our base from the level that I had gotten to before. Probably can do more later on. I might not have even been up to date. It was just the level from the last time that I had put a base together. Or rather, the number of land balls from the last time I had. Regardless. Alright, looks like land ball is building my beds. But I need wool and cloth. I need cloth to build a cloth outfit so that I can... There we go. I need cloth to build a cloth outfit for cold resistance. Seriously, not have any foul spears on me? Okay. That was my mistake. Stone is what I'm missing. Okay. Let's go ahead. He's mining. Yeah. Pal deck. That's what I'm looking for. Alright. Lumbering is what I'm looking for. And no one has it. Okay. Now, down here were plenty of land balls, and now I have a good number of pal spheres. So, should be able to get all of the wool and fiber that I need. Wait, there were a lot of land balls down here. I did not mean to kill him, but at least they're both males. I need to craft a bow. don't know if it'll capture, but it's worth a try. Okay, you're basically dead, so you better capture. I'm gonna go ahead and go down to that fast travel point, assuming I survive. If I don't survive, well, I'll end up back at my base. Oh, there's an egg down there. Oh, and a chest. That guy is hostile, though. All right. So. The whole point of this was to get an hour of recording with, being connected to the internet, because it will crash if you're not connected to the internet and you die. So, I wanted to get an hour of recording, and I'm going to wait until tomorrow before I come back to play anymore. And I'm going to check my hotspot data usage to see how much an hour of play takes in data. So that's where we're at. That was the entire purpose of that test save. Died once. Dying once an hour is reasonable in terms of how much it's going to tell me to save. I think it also saves when I craft things. So, probably have a lot of saves in there. So, yeah, I just wanted to see what an hour of play, an hour of, base building, collecting, that kind of thing. See what it costs for data usage to see whether or not it's smart to keep playing this on a hotspot. Of course, I'd prefer not to be on a hotspot, but that's all I have for internet right now. Anyway,